All right, ladies and gentlemen, our first gentleman for the evening, we have Andrew Encinas. Let's give a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, next we have the parents, Mr. and Mrs. Encinas. And Mr. Ritz. Our next couple for the evening, the matron of honor, Cindy Miller, and the best man, Luis Cusmario. This evening, ladies and gentlemen, we have Wendy and Adrian Crawford. Next couple for the evening, we have Katie Allen and Clinton Ricks. And Justin Allen. Garcia and Elijah Ricks.
give him a round of applause. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, our next couple for the evening, we have Dio Bamboya and Paul Irons. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have Brianna McLaughlin and Jimmy Herzos. All right, and to our next couple, we have Jen and Eugene Mendoza.
Yeah.
Let's give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, I'll invite you to please take your seats.
Well, throughout the course of the weekend, we have all shared many laughter, many tears, many fun stories, many heartfelt stories, and some stories that we probably didn't want to hear. So, on that note, I'm just going to do a simple toast and then I'll hand it over to you. I just wanted to say that, you know, I love you both so much, and Ron and I are so proud of the two of you, and, you know, I just pray that God's wisdom would always guide your steps, that His blessings and grace would be upon you always, and that His love would always fill your hearts for one another all the days of your life. May your sorrows be few, and may your children be many.
Thank you, thank you. This is a very special day. My baby brother is married. I remember the day I came home and he came home from the hospital. I came back from a trip from the Boy Scouts. I was 10 years old. And my mom and his dad were in my kitchen. And there he was. Remember that, lovely? He was a little tiny peanut with a head of black hair. And then he just started to grow and grow. And he became the most adorable, caring little boy that we all wanted to be around. He was such a special little guy that just made us all so happy. There was a couple of close calls. My Uncle Gene will remember. Remember when he fell in the pool? And my Uncle Gene had to resuscitate him? That was a close call. Not a lot of you might know that, but he's been a very special guy in our lives. And then when our mom got sick, we relocated. I moved into California. Chris went to Seattle. Lovely was in LA. And I think that's when we really realized how much we love each other. Because in the summers, Chris would come to California. And those were the best summers, though, Chris. It was just him and I for months at a time. And I would want nothing but to just spend it with my baby brother. We went to Malibu, Mexico, Laughlin, horseback riding on the beach, just hiking in the woods. We spent so much time together. And there was nothing more that I wanted to do than to be with him. And I know he feels the same way. And meanwhile, he kept growing. And then next thing I know, I have this 6'4", 215-pound football star. Boom. What happened to my little brother? But his heart was still the same. He was still the exact same guy. He had the same personality as when he was a little boy. Nothing changed him. Because he had all the love from all of us. Yeah, well, one thing I can say about Chris is he has charisma. And charisma is defined as making someone feel very special about themselves, everyone. And it takes half empathy and half confidence. And that's what Chris has, and that's what he does for everyone. Anita. So many of you already know that they met in high school and then went their separate ways. And then by the grace of God and of the help of Anthony, we got back together. And my brother-in-law said it yesterday, and I'll say it again. Anita and Chris are the same. They have the same values. They hold the same things dear, and they cherish the same thing. And you value family. You know, when Chris was 3,000 miles away at Florida State, Anita would come to our family good functions without him. She was family before she was family. And that meant a lot to me and to our family. We love you for it. And her and I spent time together, just her and I, in Florida, watching Chris's game, at very difficult times, you know? And I got to be alone with Anita, and there wasn't one thing that she did to bother me in the slightest bit. Not one frown, not one negative comment about someone saying whatever. She just held herself like a princess. She held herself like a queen. She held herself like my brother's wife should. It was the best. Her family, they'd seen us, embraced my brother and our family so wholeheartedly and lovingly. We've been to their house so many times, and they have embraced my brother and taken care of him as a son before he officially was, as tonight. And I thank you for it and love you for it. So together, I know Anita means the world to Chris, and Chris means the world to Anita. Their faith in each other, their faith in God, and their love from everyone will ensure they'll be together forever. So with all that said, everyone please raise your glass and give all your infinite love to Mr. and Mrs. Chris Grace.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Fred Encinas, and on behalf of the Encinas family, my wife Kathy, and the rest of our family members here, I'd like to welcome you to the wedding reception for Chris and Anita Riggs. And I don't know what's left to say about these two young people here. We've had a wedding rehearsal dinner. We've had other gatherings where there's been a lot of things said about Chris and Anita. But I can just share with you a couple of memories I have about my daughter first. I remember 1980 when she was born. And I just want to say that she was been quite a dog. If any of you have been through a Lamaze class, I had all the classes, but I wasn't prepared for what happened. The night she was born, we had to go to a special surgery room, and we delivered her. And she was delivered, and she came out kind of purple. And she had these white eyes, and she was purple, and she looked quite happy. And I go, oh my God. And I was taken aback. I go, why was purple? But this little baby grew into a beautiful princess, a fine young woman. As she started to get older, we joined what's called the Union Princess Group through the YMCA. And Nita, being the dancer that she was, she picked a name, because all the dads and the daughters had to have an Indian name. And her name was Little Dancing Pony. And she danced all the time. She have quite a time for us to call her dancing. But as she grew up, and I can't believe Anita, she's always had good values. She always was very kind to everybody. She's always had a loving heart. And as she got older and older and older, she always extended herself to everybody, anybody in her neighborhood, anybody in her school, anybody that she worked with. She always was there. She was there for her family. She would be there for Chris. And I love her, and I wish the best for her. And lastly, I'd like to say something about my new son-in-law. First time I met Chris was from afar. And those of you who know this area, Bishop Vermont is a high school that's in La Puente. And that's where I first came across Chris Riggs. Kathy had told me about this kid named Chris Riggs came to the car and started talking to her. And I don't know what that was about, but I could see where that was going to go. So I guess it must have been just a few weeks into our freshman year. I used to take Nita to school every morning. She said, Daddy, I'm going to go with this kid named Chris Riggs. I said, what does that mean? Well, he's my boyfriend. Oh, really? And so, okay, all right, well, let's see where that's going. So then just a couple weeks later, she said, Daddy, guess what? I broke up with Chris Riggs. I said, what happened? She said, he tried to kiss me. And I said, yeah, you gotta move on. You're too young for that. You gotta find that. But after that moment when I met Chris and I seen him on the baseball field, then I got to know him as a young athlete at the school. Chris has had a lot of challenges in his life. He gained a lot of respect for him. He's quite a man. He's had a lot of adversity. He's always persevered. And one of the biggest things Chris has never done, he's never compromised his values. His values for his family, the values of God, and the values he holds most dear, which is that for himself, it is his credibility. And those of you who know me, I've worked all my life to maintain credibility and ethics and everything that I do and try to maintain my lifestyle. And I know Chris will carry on with my daughter in the same manner. He'll take good care of my daughter. And I welcome you to our family. God bless you. To Chris and Anita, may you have many, many years of happiness and love. And just part of what my wife has given me through the years, of encouragement and love and support. I pray that you have that plus more. God bless you.
Amen. I just want to take a moment to say that she sees you, she's watching you, and she loved him so much. If you take all the love that we all have for Chris and add it up, that's how much my mom loved him. And I know she's looking down at you, Chris. Never forget her, okay? But thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we invite Chris and Anita to come and cut their cake. Looks like they're already here and ready. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a round of applause.
Inside.
Give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
At this time, we're going to open up the dance floor just a little bit. Get you guys moving. So we invite you to come and celebrate for Chris and Nina. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, don't be shy. Come on, everybody. There we go. Come on!
want to make some noise for this gentleman right here. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause. Wonderful smoothie actions.
We on?
Who this for? This for Fox? MTV?
Yeah, you know, we just won the Super Bowl and we going to Disneyland, and
they don't go to Disneyland no more.
Disneyland?
No, they go to New Orleans.
We going to New Orleans.
New Orleans,
that's where I'm from.
Festival.
The festival. I'm from the 17th Ward. You heard me?
I'm from the 21st Ward.
Down in the California.
No, but anyway,
Chris. You say Anita? I say Chris. You say
Anita?
We're just so happy
to be here
with you and sharing in this moment. We love
to be around you guys. You're such an encouragement, and the Lord is
good
all the time, and
all the time
God is good.
We just like to thank you for your friendship and
memories and your heart and the type of people that you are, because
God is good
all the time.
And all the time,
God is good. God bless you. Be with your finances.
Good night.
Make sure you give me a love offering on the way out.
Good night.
Talking about this kind of love offering.
Good night.
God bless.
Good night.
Thank you and good night.
Good night.
All right. I'll let you boy.
Hi, Chris and Anita.
Hi, Anita. Hi, Chris.
we love love you both very much. We're so excited we can be part of this whole festivities. Yeah.
I hope you guys, I wish you well in everything. And Elkie, I love you to death. And Chris, I love you too. Even though everything went down, I'm really excited for you guys and I'm really happy. And
everything's gonna work out. You're lucky.
And they are going to be in California, and I'm so excited about
that.
You
need to come visit Tallahassee.
Remember, Tallahassee is hot, and we don't want to have another Tallahassee incident. So we're going to say they're pulling on us, and I guess they're ready to go. So we do love you.
Bye.
All right, Chris and Anita, wanted to say hello again and just wanted to let you know how proud I am of both of you. I love you so much and just so proud of you. My heart is filled with joy today. Again, because of the way that you've loved God and you've honored Him and the way you love one another and the way you've loved us. Thank you so much for allowing us to share in your lives, and it's been a great adventure. We know that the adventure is just beginning, and I want you to know that we're always here for you. Anything we can do to help you to continue in this journey of faith to be great, we are here for you. www.aimforgreatness.com. With the Chris Ricks sign, football, go Chris Ricks. Back in Cali, promoting it up. Just remember, stay humble, Chris Ricks. You got to stay humble, my friend. Conservative South values. Don't forget, Tallahassee is the center of the universe. So I'm believing we'll be reunited again like Han Solo and Luke. And I'm not even a big Star Wars guy. So God bless y'all. Have a great honeymoon. I don't know if you'll see this at the honeymoon or when you get back, but have a great time. Look forward to talking with you. And when you get back, you have 1 month to get my garage cleared out, or it's all going to Goodwill. God bless you. Love you. Bye.
Chris, Anita, congratulations. We love you guys very much.
Hope you guys have a long and happy life together and many babies.
Many, many babies. Love you
love
guys.
Love you guys. Hi, guys. I just want to say congratulations. You two have made the most beautiful couple I've ever seen. The wedding was amazing. And I know that you guys are going to have just a remarkable marriage. You two are so perfect for each other. The love that you have for one another, it shows in everything that you do for one another. So I just want to say congratulations. I love you both so much. Thank you so much for letting both of us be a part of this day. I couldn't be happier for you both.
Hey, Chris and Anita, I just want to say I love you both. You've been a big part of my life. You're two of my best friends. Awesome, Anita, you look so beautiful today. Chris, beautiful groom too. You're beautiful, we know that. I just want to say I love you both, and I hope you have an amazing life together, and beautiful children. I hope that we are a part of their lives and still be a part of yours. Love you both.
Hello, this is your brother, Adam. I just want to say God bless you guys. You guys are awesome. I really look up to you guys, and I'm proud of you guys that you guys were able to go through what you had to go through, and have fun on the honeymoon. Chris, take care of my sister, or I'll be coming after you.
I just want to say congratulations, Anita and Chris. I'm so proud. I know how much this day is going to mean to you, because last year, and I'm honored that Anita was by my side and I'm by hers today. I love you both, and hopefully we get to see each other more often now that you're married. We have another little couple to hang out with.
Anita and Chris, I wish you the best of luck and God bless you in your future marriage. I know, Anita, me and you have talked about this day since we were little girls. So congratulations, you've had your dream wedding, and I wish you the best of luck, and I love you lots. Woohoo!
Just kidding. Chris, Anita, congratulations. We're more than glad to be such a part of your wedding. It was absolutely a great time. Look forward to spending more time with you and Anita. Family functions, Christmas, New Year's, all over the place. We're just very proud of you both. We hope to see you soon. Have a great time in Hawaii. Here's Jennifer.
We love you guys. Thank you so much for including us on your day. You guys are awesome. We're so glad that you're part of our family officially now, Anita. We love you guys so much. Congratulations. Mason, say love you, Uncle Chris and Auntie Anita.
All right. Love you. Bye.
Hi, Niti and Chris. We are so honored to be a part of your big day. It's been wonderful so far. God has totally been present. We love you. We look forward to your future and all the great things and the great kids ahead. We just can't wait to get to the East Coast to come visit. We'll miss you a lot. Love you.
Hi, Anita and Chris. I love you. You know how proud I am of you and how honored I am to be in this wedding. And I'm excited to see what God has for you in the future. I know there's no end to his blessing for your lives. And so sad to see you here in California, but I'm sure we'll see you a lot in Tallahassee and at all of our wonderful conferences. So I love you guys. Mwah.
Mr. and Mrs. Christopher Ricks, congratulations. Forget what everybody has said. Every bit of advice, just remember these two advice. Love God and love each other. Anita, you're one of the most wonderful people I've ever met. And Chris definitely outputted his coverage when he married you. Chris, listen to me. You've taught me so much. I respect you. I love you. And I don't know what I'm going to do without a Chris Ricks on the sideline with me after 4 years. Know that I'm here for both of you. Know that I love you. Know that I'm proud of you. And most of all, know that I'm praying for you. God bless you and have a great life. Bye-bye.
I'm standing here in front of you, and you are here with me. So unbelievable, I never ever let you go. My heart is yours for keeps.
Let's make a vow,
baby.
Right here.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
We first met here at Bishop Amat Memorial High School
in 1996 when I was 13 and he was 14, and I think we had a freshman algebra class together.
She was in I believe it was drill team or getting ready for cheerleading, and I was in 2-a-days of my freshman football team.
I would sometimes notice this boy kind of looking back at me, kind of staring, but I never would really say anything.
I just remember the first time I saw her, I kind of, my jaw just kind of dropped.
I was like, ooh, Chris Ricks, he's pretty hot and buff.
Kind of like in the movie Big Fish, he says, when you see the love of your life, time kind of stops. And I remember it kind of being like that.
We started talking on the phone every single night after cheer practice and football practice.
And I remember we were either going to a birthday party or something that night, so I was on an emotional high. I knew I was going to see her, so I basically just asked her over the phone.
I had to get off the phone quickly because I was going to go out to dinner with my family. And he said, no, you can't go yet. I have to ask you something.
If she would be my girlfriend. I think I said, you know, would you like to be my girl?
And I was like, sure. I'm like, but I gotta go.
And I just remember, you know, the emotion and the excitement. I felt I was on top of the world. I felt I was on cloud nine and I could do anything.
So after that, we were considered to be boyfriend and girlfriend. But it wasn't for very long. It was very short-lived.
So we dated for the next couple weeks. And then before we went to another birthday party.
And he brought me a note and a Nike ring, because I was wearing his Nike ring, so he bought me my own.
And I had written her a letter, wrapped it up nice, put, a flower with it, and gave it to her at that party that night, not thinking it was any big deal.
And the letter said some lot of sweet things. I was loving the letter.
I wrote P.S. on that letter, I love you.
And then at the very end it said, P.S., I love you.
I was so just emotionally attached to her, and I guess just the fact I was moving too fast.
I kind of started freaking out, and things changed after that, and I started just getting kind of antsy. And
that following Monday at school, she gave me the ring back, and I was right in front of her locker. We were about to go to class, and
said, I can't be with you anymore. There's a lot of things going on in my life, and I just can't be your girlfriend anymore. So he walked me to my locker.
And I just remember how heartbroken I was. And it's almost like she had taken all that excitement and everything I'd been feeling for those 2 weeks just out.
I was putting my books in my locker. I didn't want to make eye contact with him because I felt so bad. And he gave me a kiss on the cheek, and he said, okay, and he walked away.
It was hard. Even though I was just a freshman in high school, it was definitely hard because I could be an emotional person.
For some reason, it just really didn't faze me too much, but I was oddly going through this phase where I liked the chase of getting the guy, and once I had him, I'd break up with him.
I said, why are you breaking up? What happened? She said, well, he tried to kiss me. I said, oh, yes, yes, you gotta break up with this guy.
When I broke up with Chris, my mom had had it. She said,
you what?
No, you cannot do this anymore. You can't be hurting these boys' hearts like that.
After the relationship with Chris and Anita ended, I remember Chris would often come over to my van as I was parked in the parking lot at Bishop Walmart, and sometimes he'd be hot and sweaty in his football gear, but he would always come over and greet me. I think it was probably to sneak a peek at Anita.
My mom really loved Chris, and there was something different about him, and she was not too happy with me after I broke up with him.
I remember sophomore year of high school, I was going through some medical problems, and Anita and Chris were both seeing other people at the time, but I remember getting the most heartfelt card from him, and just telling me that he didn't really know what was going on, but that he knew Anita was worried about me and was praying for me, and he wanted me to know that he was praying for me also. And I think at that point, he got a little special place in my heart that I don't think ever went away. I don't think of very many young men who are 16 years old taking the time to go to the store and buy a get well card and write such a heartfelt note. It meant the world to me, and I think from that point, Chris Ricks, he locked a special place in right in the pit of my heart.
After my freshman year at Florida State, we were both in our sophomore years, and I was about to start on the football team, and we just saw each other on Instant Messenger one night.
All of a sudden, I get from Noel QB16, hey Anita, and I respond back, hey Chris, and he says, what are you doing? And I'm like, well, just broke up with my boyfriend, and he said, oh really?
I remember a big smile coming over my face and looking up and just thanking God that he had answered my prayers, because I would always think, even when I was in relationships with other people, if I could just have one more chance, and God, if you would just give me one more chance with Anita, I promise I wouldn't blow it, and I would use wisdom and do things the right way. But never in my wildest dreams thought that I would get another chance to be in a relationship with her.
I think it was maybe 5 minutes after that my phone was ringing and Chris was on the other line asking what I was doing. And from that day on, we talked every day, whether it was on the phone or whether it was online. I know I always tried to go online at the same time every day, hoping that he was going to be on there.
Shortly after that, she made her first trip out to Florida, and we saw each other. We hadn't seen each other in over a year since her graduation party.
My mom, she really encouraged me to take this trip because she's like, you need to figure out what you're going to do because you got it bad. And she's like, you're either going to be in a relationship or not.
And I said, you know, you really need to go and figure out what direction this relationship is going.
My mom and dad paid for me to go out to Tallahassee and see him. And the moment I laid eyes on him again, he was just completely different. And I remembered him from high school. I always thought he was attractive. When I saw him again for the first time, I'm like, oh my gosh, he's gorgeous.
We went to an Italian restaurant called Al Dente right there on campus. And that was our first dinner date. And I remember how nervous I was. And
we sat outside on the porch with candles and we just talked the whole time. And I was falling for him real hard.
You know, my hands were shaking and didn't really know what to order and was watching every bite I took to make sure I didn't embarrass myself.
I hope the whole what goes around comes around doesn't happen to me because I broke up with him 4 years ago. I was really hoping that that wasn't gonna happen to me.
By December, sitting in the hallway at the Gator Bowl, he called her up and asked her to be his girl.
So yet again, he asked me to be his girlfriend over the phone, but this time I wasn't complaining at all and I was very excited. So on December 27th, 2001, I was officially Chris's girlfriend and very happy at that.
I thought that was great that he gave her enough time to kind of put the old relationship behind her, but was patient enough with her to kind of wait for the right time.
On February 5th, 2005, Chris had asked me earlier in the day to save the evening because we were going to go out to dinner, but he wasn't going to tell me where.
I talked to the current principal, Dr. Hemingway, who was a principal my senior year at Santa Margarita, and he arranged for the football lights to be on the stadium, the gates to be open.
So after dinner, it was still early, and we were driving home. And he all of a sudden says, oh no, I got on the wrong freeway. And I'm like, oh, that's okay. This freeway can still take us home.
I kind of just said, hey, you want to stop by Bishop Amat? And she said, sure.
And he drove me here to Bishop Amat. And we're driving down the street and he says, wouldn't it be cool if the football lights were on? I said, yeah, but it's Saturday, like almost 9 o'clock. They're not going to be on.
We walked down on the football field, took a couple laps around the field, stopped.
And he says, let's pray. And so he grabs my hands and he was just thanking God for me and our relationship and that I was everything he wanted and needed in a girl.
And then after that, I just simply said, Anita Marie Encinas, will you marry me?
And before he even said that, I was already crying.
A big smile came on her face. She started crying and I showed her the ring and she said yes.
I was just so excited. It was the moment I had dreamed of my whole life, and it was so perfect, and it was very sentimental because it was in a place that both meant a lot to both of us.
It was nice, and it was exactly what I wanted.
Our hearts forever. Excited to have him come home to me every day and just be able to do the normal things.
Each other, wake up next to each other every morning, and just the little things, just the simple things I think we're looking forward to, because it has been a challenge.
Nita and Chris have a great foundation for their marriage. Number one, it's founded in God, and their faith in God, their love of God, their sharing of their faith, not only with each other, but those around them who they witness to.
From the father's side, I wish the best to Chris and Anita. As Kathy said, for Anita and Chris, they need to be close to God. Because if you don't build a house on the rock, you build it on sand, your house of marriage will not last.
But if you stay committed in that love and in that relationship, you'll be able to work through any problem.
And I wish them the best, and I pray for them.
And we love you both.
I love you both, guys.
I'm just so thankful that I'm going to be marrying Anita. She's been the girl of my dreams even before I met her. I knew there was someone for me. And I got a glimpse of it for 2 weeks, and then I prayed over the next couple of years that, God, if I could just have another chance with her. He was so faithful to give me another chance with her. And just to know that I'm going to be spending the rest of my life with her excites me. I'm very excited about that.
We're just so thankful to have everybody here on our special day. To share in it, because this is a day that we'll remember for the rest of our lives, and it wouldn't be the same without all of you here to share in our day. And we just love you all so much and are just so thankful to have you in our lives.